it's the body for me.
Stand up, it
looks
good.
It do. It looks really good. So this is glass number 2.
That's 3.
Sorry. What'd you say?
That's 3.
Big Blanco, big Don. This is, I'm scared now. Bruh,
hold
no,
on. Hold on.
Because look, on New Year's, a nigga poured almost a damn whole bottle 42 in my mouth.
Hold on.
And it was all of my dress. Thank God I had like a little velvet dress. It dried up quick. But
that shit run the back of your body, girl.
PTSD.
Girl, pour this damn shot, but he's supposed to find your ass. Crazy to yourself.
Good morning. So I've been away, and I've been away for a while, so I wanted to wake up and jump right into it. This morning I am cleaning up my kitchen. I am packing my clothes for a weekend vacation, and I also needed to wash clothes. But what I wanted to bring you guys along for was this unboxing I've been meaning to do for a week and a half now. So that's how I figured I'd start my morning. So like I was saying here, I'm gonna start the morning with a unboxing that I've been putting off for like a week and a half. Just from a mix of places, including Zara, this collab, Victoria's Secret, this other website. So yeah, let's dive into it. And I'm so glad I found them. So I got these wide rise full length boot cut jeans from Zara, and I had seen them on TikTok. This like fashion girly, I had seen her with these on, and I thought they were so cute. But I figured they didn't look right on me because I thought she was taller. But these look so bomb on me. I'm gonna take these on vacation. And I'm probably gonna wear it with like a bralette or something. We'll see. But I was super excited about those. And they fit like chef's kiss. So I'm super stoked about those. Anybody that knows Zara knows that their stuff isn't, their stuff is reasonably priced. And the quality, I don't know, it's like hand in hand, so I don't ever mind spending the price tag at Zara because you know the pieces are gonna last. But speaking of Zara, I got another piece. This one I had to get shipped in because it wasn't available in any of the stores in Atlanta. How do you get into this box? Oh, there you go. This is Zara featuring Ruigi, the creator of the brand Rude. He had went in and redesigned all of the everyday uniforms. So I saw these factories. They were for men, but I was obsessed with them. Oh, look, I fit up. This is so cute. Like, throw them real quick. A little bit more than sweatpants, but very much easy breezy, you know? These might be my favorite piece so far. Actually, let's see if y'all can see it. So cute. I'm so glad. Okay. For the next piece. Oh, these were exciting. I saw these. I've been meaning to buy from this brand for a while, but I don't know, like, I just love all things black. So I didn't want to go too much out of my, like, my uniform. That's the word I wanted to use. So this is from, I think her name is Samaria Lee. About these reconstructed sweatpants. These are so cute to me. These reconstructed sweatpants. Very heavy weight. Those are so long. And I actually scored them on sale when I finally pulled the trigger, so that was a win all the way around. I can't complain. I don't know where I'm gonna wear those though, but I wanted them, so I got them. Y'all know what I'm talking about? This right here. I think this is from one of those one-off websites. I'm not really sure where this one's from. A brand named Daisy, D-A-Z-Y. These are just traditional track pants. So I ordered these one time and they were a tad bit too small. Like, I couldn't gain any weight in them because then I would have outgrew them. So I ordered a size bigger so that I can take them to go get altered. But yeah, just your traditional throw on track pants. Very uniform, very cute, very classic. And y'all already know what time it is. So, I was excited about this one. So I bought this two-piece. Chrissy. But to not, and pants that. I'm gonna show y'all a shirt. Oh, shit. Okay, so this is the button up, and it came with a matching pants to make a set. So I had bought this in two different colors because I saw it, I was obsessed with it. I said that just screams summer, fall, really any season. So I had bought the black, of course, and then I was like, let me try something a little bit different. So I bought this like summer cream, beige, champagne. Oh, they say cream. I have had a cream version also. So I'm super excited about that. I bought this like oversized acid wash. I didn't have this color, so I bought that. Victoria's Secret was having a sale. Goes without saying, I had to re-up. No need to show y'all because y'all know exactly what's going on. But very cute. This one is from one of my good friends, based out of Jersey right now. And he has a brand called Busy Works. I'ma link it below. But he has sent me he has seeded me some items from the brand, which was super exciting. He don't miss, y'all. I need y'all to understand, he don't miss. The quality's there. Puffy paint. Let me drop something new. I'm like, bruh, I thought you outdid yourself last term, but this might be the one. So yeah, Busy Works. Tell a mail sent you. He don't know exactly what you're talking about. Don't ask me questions. Alright, what else? Alright, this one. Aside from little other stuff like this, I'm gonna show y'all one other thing, but this is gonna be the last package. And this one's from my mama. This was exciting. Wait a second. It's a whole bunch of stuff in here. Okay. Can't live without these. Cannot live without those. How cute. I miss you too, girl. I do. Can't wait to see you. Some more. Essentials. Some more. Look at her. Won't she do it? Won't she do it every time? She sent me some BHA. One of my favorite masks. The BHA. Chef's kiss. It's like she knew I needed some more. She sent me a rice classic rice powder. Ooh. Tatcha. I've been wanting to try them out. That's so funny that she sent me this because I keep hearing good things about them. But I just haven't found a product that I wanted to try yet. So she beat me to the punch. Super excited about that. Dermalogica, you can never go wrong with that. This is one of my favorite exfoliants. Love that. And a dual texture facial buffer. Cute. The pillow eye mask. Cute. Some, eye brightener under eye vitamin C mask. Ooh, that looks promising. Very promising. And some socks, love that. Some stuff I left in Maryland. Look how cute she is, look at this. That is so cute. Shout out to the girl for coming through. Yes. I'm gonna probably try this. I'm not gonna try it this weekend because I'm not gonna pack it, but maybe I will. Maybe I'll try it this weekend. And I'll record Saturday morning because that'll be pretty much the only time I have. So I probably will try it and I will let you guys know what I think about the, let me get it right. What I think about the classic rice enzyme powder. Polished enzyme powder. I will let you guys know for sure because I'm super excited. Thanks, mama. Appreciate you immensely. What else did I buy? Like I said, I bought some stuff from Sheen, but those are plastics. This is the last thing I want to show you guys. So I've been like obsessed with this. And now I'm down to my last bottle, so I might need to re-up. But the reason I'm obsessed with it is because not only is it an aloe vera mist, so I usually mist my face throughout the day, like right after I wash it in the morning, mist. Throughout the day, you know, you just need like a little hydrated pick-me-up, mist, da-da-da-da. So it gives a very light, clean finish, but also, I love the nozzle on it. Like a lot of people they underestimate the impact of a spray bottle nozzle. This brand, 10 out of 10, executed phenomenally. So I have bought my mom two, I have bought myself three, and I have to go back and buy, you know, some more. So I will be gifting all my girlfriends this. Be on the lookout. And I hope you guys are grateful. Every time. And it smells good. I'm not gonna get So there's that. There she goes. God, I wanted that hair off my neck. But yeah. So now I'm about to pack. And by pack, I mean throw stuff into a suitcase. And we finna wing it. I don't know if I told you guys where I'm going this weekend, and I probably won't. I will see if you guys can guess. But yeah, I'm back. So I can say I'm back.
By the time y'all see this vlog, y'all would know that I'm in New Orleans, and it is currently 9:33. But what I wanted to show y'all was, aside from the bananas and aside from that, they didn't go to shopping this morning. Of course, so I vowed not to drink this weekend. Well, I'm not taking hard shots. So they got Dulce, Hypnotic, somebody got Patron, some other stuff. But shout out to the person that bought this, because this is the main character for the trip. And we're going to revisit that. I thought this was cute. This is a big ass bottle, gallon, liter, 2 gallons of sangria. So I'm going to try that tomorrow. Some ginger ale. Wine, all that stuff, champagne, some of that stuff, Gatorade. We got these little freebies. If you know that I love these things. Like, keep these in my freezer. I think they're so cute. But we got a couple of those down here, down there. Y'all, it is 2:10. I had a slice of cheese pizza, no cheese. I had to come home. New Orleans is cute. This is my second time being here. So I have to say, it's a cute little place. The vibes are definitely here. The energy is definitely here. The crowd is definitely here. The food, I'm hoping that this time I have better luck with food options, because I didn't have that much luck the first time we came. So we will see. It's a place that I definitely want to go to called Drago's. So hopefully I get lucky tomorrow. But what I'm about to do is I'm about to clean off the bed. I'm about to turn on Netflix, wipe my face, then wash my face. Take a shower and let Netflix watch me. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Yeah.
For explicit content, BET Uncut.
Yeah, I know I love a good 2000 video.
In the late 1980s and early 1990s, women started becoming a prominent accessory and object for rap videos, thanks to two life.
Okay, so we ended up at Drago's, y'all, and I was trying to do a reservation because we have a party of, it's this table, that table, and I think another table, but it's like 15 of us. So I was trying to do a reservation. I think it was only 6, but they was booked until August anyway, so it doesn't matter. But they told me that these oysters was the best thing on the menu, so I bought a dozen of them. And then I'm going to also get some other stuff, so I'm gonna show y'all.
This is what I got? Yeah, that's mine. She a lot. I've never heard favorite. I'm on her favorite music. She don't call me. She said to all the nieces, "Hey, my favorite niece, what you want?"
Okay, so I'm just at a
if you know me, you know this is always my appetizer of choice.
She's been in Michigan since then. I haven't seen it.
Her dad had a birthday party, right?
Yeah, I didn't get a chance to go to that. And girl, they told you. Yeah, did they tell you about? No, I don't think Tula didn't go.
She didn't want to go. And
Haney
was like, "Well, you need to go."
The same with my family. But yeah, so it was interesting. So you know, Uncle Dave, he has a whole his white girlfriend. They've been together since before Uncle passed away. Like way before Uncle passed away.
Well, I thought him and Uncle were together.
They were together.
But they didn't act like
them. No, they never did act like them. So she was like, she was hurt. She was like, Uncle Dave crying every time white people got on the talk about him crying and shit. But she's like, when we got to talk about him, they got no care.
Y'all know I live for a good sunset, and I don't know what city or state we're in, but look at that view.